Is it visible to everyone? Okay, thank you. So in our previous lecture, we started the various line coding schemes. After discussing the characteristic properties of a line coding scheme should have, a desired line coding scheme should avoid baseline wandering. It should avoid the DC components. It should have self-synchronization capability of the clocks of receiver and sender. It should have capability to detect and correct the errors. It should be less immune to noise. It should be less complex. So after this, we started studying the older schemes, that is unipolar, non-return to zero, that is the voltage or current level which represents a bit, remain either above the axis or below the above the axis. Then we studied the polar scheme. In polar scheme, we have the non-return to zero, return to zero, biphase Manchester, and differential Manchester. So in that we have studied the two, that is NRZ. NRZ has two schemes, non-return to zero level, in which the level of the bit will decide the voltage is. It will represent a bit 0 or a bit 1. In non-return 0 invert, the inversion or lack of inversion will decide the bit. So in continuation, let us discuss today the pitfalls or drawbacks of NRZL and NRZI schemes. So this was the last diagram of our previous lecture, which is for non-return to zero level. That is, a voltage level will decide a bit 0 or a bit 1. In non-return zero inversion, the 1 bit represents a inversion. You can see here, let me highlight. You can see here, inversion will be represented by next bit is 1. If next bit is a 0, then there will be no inversion. You can see here, the string is 0, 1. So, bit starts from this voltage level, 1 will represent a change, so it will come, voltage level will come towards the negative. Next bit is 0, voltage level will remain same. Next is 0, voltage level will be same. And 1, the voltage level will change. Again, we have a 1, again, the voltage will towards the negative here. And we have a 1, again, voltage level will change. Then we have a 0 end, right, extreme right. So voltage will remain there. So if we want to summarize these two, then we can see that in NRZL, it is the level which is changing the voltage corresponding to bits 0.1. In case of NRZI, the inversion or lack of inversion decide. If a bit is 0 and next bit is also 0, the voltage level will remain same. If we have a 1 in the stream, then whenever we obtain 1, voltage level shift from negative to positive or from positive to negative. So these two schemes are summarized in the last line on this slide. In NRZ level, the level of the voltage will determine the value of the voltage. Whereas in NRZI, the inversion or lack of inversion will determine the value of the bit. Here you can see on the slide, the solid dot represents a inversion, and this inversion will take place whenever a 1 appears in the bit stream. Whenever in the bit stream a 0 is there, there will be no inversion. So this is all we studied yesterday. Now let us study the draw X or bit pulse of these two schemes, bipolar and polar, non-return to zero unipolar, and bipolar, non-return to zero level, and non-return to zero inversion. Baseline wandering is a problem for the both NRZ as well as NRZI. And this baseline wandering is twice severe in NRZL as compared to NRZI. This baseline wandering occurs when we have a long sequence of zeros or ones. In NRZL, the average signal is huge. The receiver might have difficulty in judging. Bit string means judging a bit value. Zero inversion, this is a long sequence of zeros. Whereas this sequence, this problem exists in case of non-return to zero level for both sequence zeros and ones in continuity. If we have a bit stream, large bit stream, and it has continuous zeros and ones, then this may cause a problem into non-return to zero level scheme. And this continuity of zeros or ones will also cause a problem for non-return to zero inversion. Generally, the long sequence of zeros will cause problem to the non-return to zero inversion scheme. So baseline wandering is present in both the stream. For both bits, it is present for NRZL. For long sequence of 0 bits, it is present for NRZI. So this is not a desirable feature. We do not want the baseline wandering. So a good scheme should not have a baseline wandering. But these both schemes have baseline wandering, so they cannot be a good coding scheme. The second problem is with the synchronization. We have already discussed synchronization means the clock at sender and receiver should be at the same instance, same time. This synchronization problem also exists in both NRZL as well as NRZI. But this problem is more serious in case of NRZL as compared to NRZI. However, the problem exists for both. But it is more serious, more severe in NRZL than NRZI. Again, a long sequence of zeros can cause a problem in both the schemes, which is nothing but a baseline wandering. The third problem with the NRZL occurs when there is a sudden change of the polarity in the system. Sudden change of the polarity means if we use twisted pair of cables to transfer the data. We have already discussed in our first unit that we can transfer the data by physical means or by using some radiations. Radiations in this space, electromagnetic radiations in this space, or we can use the physical connected mediums through which we can transfer the data. So twisted pair cables are the optical fiber cables or waveguide cables in which we transfer the data. So for such type of cables, a polarity is changed when a cable is twisted. So due to that twist, there is finite chance that All zeros may be interpreted as ones, or all ones may be interpreted as zero. NRZ inversion does not have this problem. NRZ level has this problem. Because in NRZL, the level is deciding the bit. In NRZI, it is the inversion or lack of inversion will decide the bit. Here we considered the if one appears, then the inversion will take place. If a next bit is zero, no inversion will take place. However, reverse is also true. We can also fix a zero for inversion and one for no change or no inversion. The fourth problem with both the systems, unipolar and bipolar coding schemes, is the power density. So we can see from the figure that this lower part, which is shown by this solid curve in red color, maroon color, you can see this curve has a huge amount of power consumed by the frequencies in smaller part. So we know when we talk about frequencies which are small, in that case we say the DC component may be present in the signal, in the data. And DC component is once again an undesirable feature for any coding scheme, just like the baseline wandering and synchronization. So a good coding scheme should not have a baseline wandering. It should have self-synchronization clocks at sender and receiver. It should not have a DC component. But these both NRZI and NRZL bandwidth graph tells us that the power is maximum consumed by the lower frequency components. Am I audible? Okay. बीच में बता देना भाई कोई दिक्कत आए तो, ठीक है? Network आज थोड़ा issue है तो कोई दिक्कत आए phone कर देना बीच में. So these were the problems with these two coding schemes. So if we look at these errors, then we can say these two coding schemes does not meet our criteria. What is our criteria? Our criteria has 5 or 6 parameters. A good coding scheme should not have a baseline wandering, but these both have. A good coding scheme should have self-synchronization capability. Receiver sender clock should remain the same, but in these two coding schemes, self-synchronization is missing. DC components should not be there, but DC components are present in both the schemes. The frequency, lower frequencies consumes more power. So, due to these problems, we can say that NRZL, NRZI, bipolar as well as NRZ unipolar coding schemes are not suited for coding purpose, and they are obsolete nowadays. We do not use these coding schemes. They are off the trend now. Now let us move to the next coding scheme, that is we have discussed these unipolar, polar. Now let us discuss the bipolar. In polar, we have biphase as well, which are Manchester and differential Manchester and return to zero. The third type of coding scheme is the return to zero. The main problem with the non-return to zero coding scheme was that sender and receiver clocks were missing in the synchronization. They were not synchronized. So this problem is resolved by return to zero coding schemes. So here in this coding scheme, we have 3 levels for representing a bit. Positive level, a zero level, a negative level. So these 3 voltage levels will decide a bit. Earlier we were having only 2 levels, positive negative for the bipolar and 1 level for unipolar. Now here each bit is represented by the positive zero and negative voltage level. There is one more change in this coding scheme, that the signal changes not between bits but during the bit. With the help of a diagram we will explain it. Now due to three voltages levels for single bit, there is a problem in this scheme as well. Here two signal changes are required for a bit to represent. So due to this we require a larger bandwidth for the return to zero coding. The large sequence of zeros and ones will also cause a problem in the this coding scheme due to sudden change in the polarity. That is, whenever data is transferred from the sender to the receiver through a twisted pair cable, in such a cable at twist, the zeros and ones voltage levels will transferred into one another and they are reversed, and this may cause a problem in the signal. DC component are absent in this. We will see with the help of a diagram that why DC components are missing here. The another problem is the complexity of this coding scheme. Why this coding scheme is complex? Because it uses three voltage levels for representing a bit, positive, zero and negative. So due to three representations for single bit, this becomes more complex, and it is more complex to create such a signal and also more complex to retrieve the data at the receiving end from such a signal. So there are both type of difficulties in converting the data into three signals for one bit and also retrieving the data at the receiving end. So due to all these difficulties, the return to zero coding scheme is also not used nowadays. So this is the return polar RZ, that is return to zero coding scheme. Here you can see there are three voltage level for each bit. Let me erase first. After that we will discuss. Okay, this is a zero and it is represented by this one level, this ground level two, and this upper level 3. Similarly, 1 is also represented by 3 bits, 3 voltage level, sorry, high level, this low level, and this change in this. So, 3 type of changes are there for a bit. So, due to these positive, negative, zero bits, positive negative zero voltage levels for representing a bit, these schemes become more and more complex, because every bit requires at least 3 levels for representing a bit. Now the problem of DC component does not present over here. Why? Because if you see at the graph shows in lower portion the frequencies are not present for this power density in the lower region. So in this region the power is very less, so small frequencies consume less power, high frequencies consume more power, which is shown by this arrow in the middle of the curve. So due to this reason the DC components are missing in this coding scheme. The next coding scheme is the biphase Manchester or differential Manchester. This coding scheme, you may use the return to zero as well as non-return to zero. The scheme which uses return to zero plus NRZL to represent a bit is called as Manchester coding scheme, and a bit which is represented by using RZ and NRZI coding scheme is called as differential Manchester. This graph shows the coding schemes Manchester and differential Manchester. The signal is zero signal is represented by this voltage level up to down, and one is represented by this voltage level from low to up or from down to top. So Manchester coding scheme, as zero is represented by this signal, the first bit is represented by a zero, which is given by the voltage signal. Can you see the cursor on the screen?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So this zero is represented by this type of signal. So in place of zero, we have put this signal. One is represented by this voltage level. So whenever from here. So in Manchester, as already mentioned, Manchester includes the RZ plus NRZL. That is this. So here the level change is deciding the bit. But in differential Manchester, it utilizes the RZ return to zero scheme and NRZI, that is NR non return to zero inversion. So here, whenever we have a next bit zero, can you see the cursor now? It is important point. Can you see?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I am circling and circling this. This solid dot. Solid dot means inversion will take place whenever the next bit in the bit stream is a zero. Else the voltage level will remain the same. Means for one, the bit will not change. So you can see the bit stream is 0, 1. 0 is represented by a voltage level, 1 is represented by another voltage level, but there is no change in the voltage whenever a next bit is 1. If you see, after these two, we have two consecutive zeros, which are again represented by voltage level, but the bit will change for 1-0 combination. Because after 1 we have a 0 and after 0 we have a 1. So again the voltage level will change. So to understand these two graphs, we should know the non-return 0 level scheme, non-return 0 inversion scheme. If you see the previous example, here if next bit is a 1, the inversion take place. No inversion will take place for 0. But in Manchester and differential Manchester, there is a reverse condition, that inversion will take place whenever we have a 0, and there will be no inversion when we have a 1. So in the bit stream, whenever the next bit is a 1, there will be a change in the level, and if bit is 0, there will be no inversion. DC component are not present in this. If you can see from the graph, the lower part does not consume, lower frequency components does not consume the maximum power of the signal. It is the higher frequencies which consume the larger part of the power of the signal. So due to these reasons, this Manchester and differential Manchester coding schemes are better than the unipolar NRZ, bipolar NRZL, NRZI, and return to zero coding schemes. So Manchester and differential Manchester coding schemes follows the criteria of a good coding scheme, and they are used till today, but there are other more advantageous coding schemes which we will study in the next lecture.